Welcome to Petersburg National Battlefield. This Civil War battlefield site was established by an act of Congress on July 3, 1926, to commemorate the campaign, siege, and defense of Petersburg in 1864 and 1865, and is managed by the National Park Service. This auto tour will take you along a 36.5-mile drive and assist you with your visit to not only the main portion of the park, but also the City Point and Five Forks units. You should plan to spend the better part of a day seeing the various battle and related sites which are encompassed in our 14-stop tour. A park ranger at the information desk will be glad to assist you with any questions you may have about the area or the drive. Be sure to refer to the park tour brochure given you at the entrance station when you use this tour tape. The map with the blue-lined route from stops 1 through 14 is the one you will follow as you move from site to site. We suggest that to more fully understand what happened at each location, you leave your car and walk the various defined trails which have interpretive exhibits and audio stations along the way. We also recommend that you see the map program in the visitor center, as well as view the museum exhibits before leaving the main parking lot. As you visit the various battle sites in the Petersburg area, you should keep in mind that this campaign lasted 9.5 months. What you will be seeing is a series of battlefields rather than just the site of one major conflict. During this time period, there would take place around Petersburg 6 major battles, 11 engagements, 44 skirmishes, 6 assaults, 9 actions, and 3 expeditions. Consequently, the battlefield of Petersburg can be said to encompass over 176 square miles. The Union Army would suffer approximately 42,000 casualties, and the Confederates 28,000, including those killed and wounded in battle and those who died of disease. The number of Northern forces involved in the campaign fluctuated between 110,000 and 120,000 men, while the Southern Army varied between 55,000 and 65,000 soldiers. Petersburg was the third largest city in Virginia at the time of the war, seventh largest in the South. The population in 1860 was around 18,000, although this rose during the siege to about 22,000 because of the refugees and military personnel who moved in. Located on the south bank of the Appomattox River at the river's fall line, Petersburg was a major port and railroad center. There were numerous cotton and flour mills along the river, and because of the railroad network, locomotive shops and ironworks. The city was also a major export center for tobacco. 5 railroads ran into Petersburg during the war, with one directly connecting with the city of Richmond, the capital of the Confederacy. 2 of these lines, the City Point Railroad and Norfolk and Petersburg Railroad, were of little consequence to the war effort since they terminated at points under Northern control. On the other hand, the remaining 2 were extremely important in providing supplies to General Robert E. Lee's Southern Army defending Petersburg. The Petersburg and Weldon Railroad ran due south from the city to Weldon, North Carolina, where it connected with other lines which brought in materials from the coast and the Deep South. The Southside Railroad ran due west to Lynchburg, Virginia, and brought in supplies from the Shenandoah Valley and Southwest Virginia. Lieutenant General Ulysses S. Grant, with his northern forces, was convinced that if he could capture Petersburg and cut off these important supply arteries, it would eventually help to destroy Lee's army and capture Richmond. When Grant was unable to take the Confederate capital by direct force in the Battle of Cold Harbor, located just outside that city, he turned his eyes upon Petersburg with the intention of reaching it before Lee's army could and capture the city. When Lee realized Grant's intention, he remarked from his position at Cold Harbor,
"Lee must destroy this army of Grant's before he gets to the James River. If he gets there, it will become a siege, and then it will be a mere question of time."
Grant and his army were successful in crossing the James River, and from June 15th through the 18th would attempt to assault Petersburg and capture it before the bulk of Lee's army could arrive from Richmond. Previous to the arrival of both armies in June 1864, Confederate authorities had built a 10-mile-long line of defenses around Petersburg, with both flanks anchored on the southern bank of the Appomattox River. Designed by Captain Charles H. Dimmock, it contained 55 artillery batteries and was known as the Dimmock Line.
It was located about 2.5 miles from the city and was held on June 15th by 2,200 Southern troops under the command of General P.G.T. Beauregard. The site of the initial attack by Union forces was here at Battery 5, where Major General William Baldy Smith and his 18th Corps captured over a mile of the Dimmock Line.